In this vlog, I will be sharing with you guys the techniques that I do to increase or boost the appetite of my chow chow. So if you want to know more, please keep on watching.
Mom!
Hi guys! Welcome again to another vlog. It's me, Mommy Nay. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, please do not forget to like and subscribe. So today, ang usapan naman natin is about feeding time. And actually, yung mga i-discuss ko dito is sort of like a recap of my weight gain journey with my chow chow. Because before nga, he was underweight. But ito, mag-a-add lang ako ng other things that I do para talagang laging kumain ang ating mga dogs. Okay, so bago muna tayo mag-concentrate dun sa talagang like appetite boosting techniques na ginagawa ko, tingnan muna natin yung mga underlying factors that could make your dog not really eat. Number one is dental diseases. Ito, isa-share ko sa inyo to guys ha, kasi si Theo ever since talagang malakas siyang kumain. Pero there's this one time na literal hindi niya ginalaw yung food niya for 2 meals. And I do fast him. I also shared this with my, ayun nga, dun sa underweight vlog ko na I am a fan of fasting. I feel like nare-regenerate ang ating mga dogs. But this time, I really felt that there was something wrong with him. Ayun, so I brought him in the hospital because nung hinahawakan ko na yung snout part niya, nag-growl siya and ayaw niya talagang ipahawak. So, I felt already that there was something wrong. So, we brought him to the doctor and we found out that meron siyang infection sa kanyang gums. So, one of his toys, nag-sharpen yun and na-infect yung kanyang gum. I'll show here. So, dyan, na-confine siya for a night because they had to monitor his temperature because it was already rising, meaning there was really an infection. It's a matter of knowing their healthy state and, alam mo yun, sticking to your routine to make sure na, ayun, he's always, alam mo yun, on point. Another cause might be related to stress and anxiety. So, ano ba yung mga stress factors na pwede mo ma-consider? Halimbawa, there is a change in the environment, or for example, may dumating na bagong dog sa inyong bahay, o kaya you simpleng umuulan, kumikitlat, this creates so much stress to your dog. So, ayun, that's another factor kung bakit talaga bumababa ang iyong appetite, ang kanilang appetite. When it comes naman to anxiety, ito yung pag napapadalas na iniiwan nyo sila, and you know, there's not so much engagement between you and your dog, yun, nagiging anxious ang iyong dog. And last but not the least na pwedeng stressor sa iyong dog to decrease their appetite is yung ano, may infection sa kanilang digestive tract or meron silang parasites. So, yun nga eh, you have to really make sure na yun, holistically, sinacheck mo ang iyong dog. Okay, so kailangan ko talaga ulit tong ulitin, but number one sa aking list is that your dog is not getting enough exercise. So, talagang malaking factor kung bakit malakas kumain si Theo is because we always make sure that he runs or he walks 2 times a day. Making sure that your dog really releases energy. When they release energy, magkikrave yung body talaga nila to eat. And yun, I think that's number one on my list talaga. Number two, you always have to check the quality and how fresh your dog food is. And malaking factor talaga yung mga dinadagdag natin sa ating mga dog food. Just to share with you, in isang very, very effective na raw ingredient na nilalagay ko sa aking dog is this. Okay, I'll share it with you guys. This is yan, quail eggs. Ang quail egg for dogs, you can actually feed them 3 to 5 quail eggs a day. So, for example, you feed them twice. Pwedeng 3 sa umaga, 2 sa gabi. Okay, quail eggs are very small, but they are packed with so much nutrients they are very high in protein and as well as their eggshell. Their eggshells naman, guys, dogs can also digest this, but hindi yung 3 eggs yung ibibigay nyo, ha. This is very high also in calcium. So there. So usually, binibigay ko lang yung isang eggshell. Ayun, minamunch na yan. Pwede yung kainin. So, meron kasing issue regarding quail eggs versus chicken eggs. Okay, so maraming mga tao that their dogs got used to eating eggs raw. Sometimes, sinusook nila yung egg. Talaga, literal as snacks. Preferably, I really go for quail eggs than this one. Because, ang sabi kasi nila talaga, if you're gonna use chicken egg, you have to cook them. Either boil them or make it scramble. And at the same time, may mga risk nga of just feeding them raw chicken egg. So, aside from the dog, naglalagay din talaga ako ng cooked food. So, kung tatanungin niyo ako personally, I don't use wet food or the ones in the cans. Ang skeptic ko, pero like, mas gusto ko talaga yung nakikita ko yung ano talagang nilalagay ko sa food ng aking dog. So, I really cook, alam mo yun, fresh ingredients such as favorite talaga ng dogs are chicken liver or breast part ng chicken. So, yun, dinadagdag ko rin yun sa kanyang diet. Next naman is investing on very good food supplements. So, when we say supplements, ito nga, diniscussed ko sa aking previous vlog, the definition of supplements. So, yun, check that out. I'll link it below also. It is very important that we also consider na we are not going to be able to give all the vitamins that our dog needs in just one meal. That's why we have vitamins, we have supplements. So, ayun, invest in good supplements. My favorite supplement is again, andun sa aking last vlog. Okay, to increase also the appetite of your dog, you have to stop giving them small treats. Sometimes talaga pag mahina sila kumain, you have to really also cut back those dental treats. Alam mo yun, yung kahit feeling mo wala sila masyadong nabibigay na calories sa iyong dog, yun, you just have to cut that back. And you have to be very strict with your schedules when it comes to your feeding time. Another effective tip for me is, again, Greek yogurt. So, Greek plain yogurt. Sorry, I have to say plain yogurt. What you can do is put it in a spoon. So, before feeding time, you let him lick it. Or also, you can directly put it in their dog food. So, yan. Very favorite yan ng mga chow-chow. Okay, last but not the least, ito share ko lang din. Sana itry nyo. Especially for double-coated dogs, ha? Kasi, ewan ko kung napapansin nyo, pero most double-coated dogs or yun, mga furry dogs, medyo mas less silang maganang kumain no summer than these times na medyo malamig na. Very normal yan. If you're watching Dr. Paul, he's a vet. He's famous in Nat Geo. He pointed out that animals really do conserve their energy during summer because init talaga drains their bodies. Eating is a very, alam mo yon, very physical activity for them because apparently they move, their digestive system works. So, alam mo yon. So, you can achieve this by making sure that the place where you feed your dog is very well ventilated or yon. Sometimes talaga, okay, ang arte na kung maarte, pero si Theo talaga nung summer, God. I guess to be honest with you, nung summer, si Tio kumakain talaga sa kwarto nun. Kasi, mainit talaga sa labas. So, yun, kailangan naka-aircon pa siya. Just freaking okay, kung susino nagsasabing low maintenance po ang chow-chow. Diyos ko, Lord, hindi po. So there. Hopefully, yun, matulungan kayo nun. Tapatan nyo sila ng fan. Or make sure nakapag-rest sila muna bago nyo sila pakainin. Nandito si Theo and he's spelling the camera. Hi, say hi first. So there you have it, guys. Hopefully, may natutunan naman kayo sa aking vlog today. I-try nyo talaga yung mga tips ko sa inyo, especially with the quail egg. Kasi talagang favorite talaga ni Theo yun. Right, Theo? So there. Thank you again for watching. See you again on my next vlog. Bye. Bye.